Well, it's Saturday. We're into our weekend now. I just finished, for all of you in the club who just recently purchased autographed pictures from me, I just finished about 26 of them. And they're all signed and in their envelopes. And Monday morning, I will take them to the post office and send them off. So they will be on their way. People have been letting me know that they've gotten theirs. I'm gonna start looking at other picture also. I've got a whole bunch of different ones, but I just wanted to let everybody know that I'm on it. And man, more than anything, when I posted yesterday about not being able to find those first videos, thank you, man. Everybody just came jumping on board with that and told me that they had them and everything, so not to worry about it. I'm going to check some settings today and make sure that everything's working properly. But it was just strange. I kept going back, and my videos all started with Bridget Bryant and Phil singing Separate Lives. So I know it's good to know they're in there. But it's just weird, technical stuff that goes on. You just kind of sometimes you just shake your head and you just go, whatever. And something that disappears one minute suddenly appears the next, and you haven't done anything except maybe pick the computer up and throw it across the room, or step on it, or drive your car over it, or my truck in my case. But I appreciate everybody jumping on board and saying, no, it's there, don't worry about it. And here's him, and people offering all kinds of fixes and stuff. So to move on with things, just really had two fabulous days with Judith Owen. And one day on Friday, what is today? Saturday, Thursday, we were, what is today? Yeah, it's Saturday. God, this is just so surreal. Just this, everything is turned into this kind of a oozy mush every day. I mean, you kind of think, oh, it's Wednesday. No, it's Thursday. I mean, I used to have defined days that I really could focus on, and now I'm just kind of you're just going, oh, I don't know what day it is. Pretty weird. But Thursday, I went to Judah's house, and we rehearsed and made some videos over there that I think she's put one of them up on her page now. And then we went in the studio yesterday and tracked them for the album. So we did like the legit versions of two of the songs. And it was great. The only thing is I'm paying the price a bit today. This is still hurting. It's going to be a long one, I think, on this, because people keep writing me with ways of dealing with blisters. This isn't a blister. This is like a real deep-seated flesh wound, meat wound. So there's no way to, relieve the pressure of it. It's just got to run its course. It's almost down near the bone. But playing was great yesterday, and it was just so great. It's just so great when you actually get together with your musicians, friends, and get to play, get to do what we do. We were all very careful. I mean, Judith only took her mask off when she was singing. And other than that, she was well masked up. We had bottles of sanitizer around her place and around the studio, and it was only the engineer and the second, and they were both masked up in the studio, and myself and Pedro and Judith. But one of the song, once again, Judith is this person that can take a song and just make it a whole other ball game by the way she interprets it. And one of the songs that she really loved and wanted to take a shot at doing was the Lovin' Spoonful's Summer in the City. So I thought I would show you their version of it, and then I'll show you what we were doing in the studio yesterday, just to give you an idea of how far removed things can get. So here is Lovin' Spoonful's version of it. And I'm not sure if the Lovin' Spoonful played on this. This is always that period of time where you wonder if, like, the Wrecking Crew guys played on it. I can't find any information, but so many records of that period was the Wrecking Crew musicians. I'm trying to reach John Sebastian now. I've bumped into John many, many times, but I don't have a current info, so I'm putting out feelers about reaching him just to kind of query him about, you know, who recorded on this. But more than anything, I want to get Judith's version of it to him because I know he'll love it. I mean, he's such a gifted, talented guy that I think he'll really enjoy it. So here's the Lovin' Spoonful doing Summer in the City. There we go.
Shadow in the city, all around people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match head. But at night it's a different world. Go out and find a girl. Come on and dance all night. Despite the heat, it'll be alright. And babe, don't you know it's a pity the days can't be like the nights in the summer, in the city, in the summer, in the city. Cool town, meeting in the city, dressed so fine and looking so pretty.
Okay, so that's the Lovin' Spoonful version of it. Now, this is us yesterday in the studio, and we're just doing some rough mixing and checking things out here. Let me see. You know, there's the thing up there.
Sorry. Hot town, summer in the city. Back of my neck getting dirty and gritty. I've been down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. Well, all around people looking off dead, walking on the sidewalk hotter than a match.
So right after this, Pedro went out and overdubbed the Sugar Bowl and Knife on this. There's going to be strings on this. We're going to get the girls from London to do the string arrangements on. Judith will do the arrangements, and they will do the unbelievable performance that they always do. So so that's what we've been up to, and I am now going to give my finger a break. I'm going to give it a day or two just to rest. I've been just sitting here looking at other songs, from Bette Midler to Peter Allen, all kinds of stuff. I'm rediscovering my own career. And it's a trip, you know, Air Supply, all these bands that I've worked with, America. So it's a real adventure for me, I'll tell you. I'm sometimes almost horrified when I look at my discography. I go, really? God. So I just want to wish everybody a great weekend. I'm going to go now. I'm going to spend the rest of the weekend, almost the solid weekend, going through pictures of... because we're trying to finalize a lot of the stuff for the book, and I've got a temp layout of everything now, and I'm seeing pictures that I want to eliminate, and then there's others that I definitely want to have in there. And I just found my parents. I got a great picture of both my folks flipping me off, which is really great. So I'm going to get that in there. So everybody, man, just take good care. Out here, I think the country's really suffering right now from heat. I know here it's over 100 degrees out here. It's supposed to be 120 degrees in Palm Springs today. And Arnold McCuller moved to Palm Springs. I should call Arnold and make sure he's not melting. But... It's pretty intense. I look outside and it almost looks overcast, and I go, it's kind of nice. And you walk outside and it's like walking into a furnace. It's like, holy crap. But I watered everything really good this morning, worked out in the yard, took the boys for an early walk before. I hate when I see people out in the middle of the day. They're out walking their dog. If you're going to walk your dog in the middle of the day, walk barefoot. You know, animals' feet can burn just as easily as a human's. They might have a thick pad on there, but it can still burn and blister easily. So if you think it's cool to take your dog out at noon or 1 in the afternoon and walk him on pavement, walk barefoot with him. See how, and then you can use yourself to determine when it's cooked enough and it's time to return home. And again, thank you to all the hard workers out there. And saying hard workers is really kind of, really is so not enough. But for the people that are working so deeply hard every day just to help us get through our days, thank you, thank you, thank you. Just take good care of yourselves, your families, your friends, and the general public. That's one of the things I love about being in a band called The Immediate Family, because at this point we are looking at the planet as our immediate family. This is really, they're just talking now that numbers have like completely, they were opening up, I think, in Paris and areas like that, trying to get it back to normal. And the numbers have gone spiked and they're shutting everything down. Marseille, they said yesterday, is suffering for it too. This has got to be baby steps, not giant leaps, getting this stuff going here. But Summer in the City, you know, I love when Judith just takes these songs and makes them her own. And the other song we did, I'm going to wait for her to put that up. It is unbelievable. It is so what's going on right now, and with a ton of attitude. And she is a piece of work. So look, have a great day, and I will see everybody tomorrow. I'm off to picture land now. So take care.